It got creased in my case. I want to wear it at Christmas, if you must know, Mary told him. But why are you hanging it there? To air it. William and Alice exchanged a pitying look, and William tapped his forehead. Do you think there's any hope for her, Will? Alice asked in a hushed voice. William shook his head gravely. She'll definitely have to be put in the loony bin, poor thing. Poor thing, Alice echoed, and she sobbed dramatically. Oh, shut up, both of you. Mary was losing her temper. If you think I'm loony, what about you two? Alice with disappearing footsteps, and you, Will, with a disappearing man. And the fox, Mary, William shouted back, losing his temper. You saw a fox, so what's so special about that? It looked at me, and the owl did. They looked at me, Mary. Then he lowered his voice to a hushed whisper, as if they were expecting me. And my dog did, Alice chimed in, not wanting to be left out of the story. The three children looked at each other in silence for a moment. But what could it mean? Mary asked. Why do all the animals look at you? And who was the man? I don't know, William said quietly. But I'll tell you something. If he'd got onto the train at the station, I'd have heard the door slam. And I didn't. I know I didn't. And if he disappeared there, then why couldn't he do it again? Out there in the snow this morning.